Hello, welcome to this is my offer episode. We will be talking about order management system today. Now, retailer sell on multiple channels, web, app, social, store, and the challenge in selling the same inventory in multiple channels is having visibility consistently what to sell where. And that's what we're going to discuss today with Nicola from Fluent Commerce. Nicola, if you introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about Fluent Commerce, we'll get started. Yes.
Sure. So I'm Nicola Kinsella and Fluent Commerce, despite our name, we don't do commerce, but we do specialize in distributed order management. So thank you so much, Ronak, for this opportunity.
So Nicola, what is order management system?
Yeah, so an order management system actually plays two key roles in digital commerce. First is inventory availability, giving you an accurate real-time view of all your inventory across all back-end systems and locations, and letting you segment that inventory and manage your safety stock so you control what you can make available to each channel, market, or region. And you can also show accurate delivery and pickup promises to your customers to build customer trust, and they're based on real-time sourcing decisions across the buying journey. The other thing it does is once an order is placed, it lets you fulfill orders from the best, most profitable location, manage the entire order lifecycle from fulfillment, including store fulfillment and returns.
Oh, that's great. So it allows one showing inventory on different channels. And if we talk about e-commerce, then it could you could be showing how much what's available for particular SKU on product detail or product listing page.
Exactly. Yeah.
So question comes up is like, can't my ERP system or e-commerce platforms do this?
Yeah, so for simple use cases, an ERP, you know, can handle some basic order management, but really they're your inventory master, right? They're a financial system of record. And while they can do basic sourcing and order management, they weren't designed for the realities of digital commerce today. Commerce platforms also weren't designed to give you fine-tuned control over inventory availability, what you're making available where. And we see so much sort of variation in how businesses want to apply safety stock. For example, one brand might want to apply a high safety stock buffer on popular items to protect an in-store experience. Another one might want to adjust them based on, you know, how long a product has been in season, like how many weeks it's been in season, because towards the end, they might have a higher cancelled order rate than they do at the beginning of the season. Or they might want to increase safety stock just after a new product launch when a particular product is in high demand. And then an order management system like Fluent Order Management is your availability master as opposed to your inventory master. It's the master of what stock you have available to promise to your customers at any point in time based on real-time complex sourcing decisions and safety stock controls. And you can do that across the shopping journey. So that includes commerce search or even you know search engine sort of search capabilities as well on the product details page at checkout, but at scale, right? So this can mean thousands of stock availability checks, including all these different sort of places across the journey every second. So you can deliver real business results. Like actually one of our customers, and this is such a fun brand, Psycho Bunny.
Wow. So one thing is, it's let's say you still have five items in store, but you don't want to make that available for BOPIS because you don't want the store shelf to look empty. And so what you're saying is with the Fluent OMS, it makes it available. It makes it possible for business user to configure what they want to sell, where, when.
Yeah. Absolutely. They can, you know, they can protect a certain amount of store inventory so they can protect that in-store experience. But it really depends on, you know, how much stock you have in each sort of product variant as to how you want to control that inventory. And
talking about results on Psycho Bunny, did that solve the problem of cancel order? Because many retailers are struggling with, you know, overselling and product not getting into canceling customer order because that hurts not only top line and bottom line.
So cancelled orders are a huge common problem, right? Really common problem. But within just a few short months after their Fluent Order Management go live, Psycho Bunny saw a 93% reduction in their cancelled orders, which means a better like overall customer experience. Another great driver of customer experience is they were able to reduce their average delivery time to an order to a customer by 33%. They also saw a 50% reduction in split shipments, which reduced their delivery costs. And as a result of their overall digital transformation, which included both commerce and order management, they saw a 30% increase in incremental revenue. And a lot of that was due to being able to make more inventory available to their digital channels because they had better inventory accuracy. And there aren't many tech investments where you can achieve that level of ROI so quickly.
Absolutely. That's pretty impressive. So what really makes the Fluent Order Management system different or from the legacy OMS or other systems, other similar systems in market?
So we used to say we were cloud native back when we were founded over 10 years ago, but these days everyone has a cloud offering, right? So really it's about the way Fluent Order Management is architected.
If I am a retailer and let's say I have 100,000 SKUs, 400 stores, and if I do the math, that makes it like 40 million inventory positions, which I want to update daily or probably more. Does Fluent OMS allow that?
Absolutely. And for fast moving items, you're going to want to update that multiple times a day or even every few minutes, right? In fact, over the 8-day Black Friday sort of holiday trading period last year, we processed 1.2 billion inventory position updates. And AWS is key to providing that scale. We use AWS Glue for fast, intelligent data processing, tenant isolation patterns here to process the data. And using AI, we process the fast-moving items or hot SKUs first, so data is available to the selling channels in a matter of minutes. And this results in both better inventory visibility and accuracy.
So that's great. I mean, no more order cancellation. But what about like each business is unique. So what about like flexibility of defining workflow or creating custom UIs for store associates?
Yeah, so that's super important. If there's one thing we've learned in years of you know, working with brands and retailers and distributors, they all have unique back-end processes. Everyone's different, which means flexibility is essential to customers. So you can fine-tune your sourcing logic and business processes to increase operational efficiency over time, like reducing order processing time and increasing your on-time and full rate. So we provide flexible workflows. You can configure using an existing library of rules. You can also create new rules and extend those workflows as well.
So can you provide some example how the customers really using this in practice?
Yeah, sure. So we have some customers who want, say, orders over a certain value to go through a fraud check review process. So they'll create a rule that puts that order in a fraud review status, triggers notification to the appropriate team members. And then once the review is complete, they will process orders as usual. Another example is customers who need very precise control over the timing of payment capture. This is particularly applicable for high-end luxury items where there's, you know, insurance ramifications and chain of custody that they have to consider around the timing of payments. Or we have customers who need special sourcing logic to factor in things like whether an item is bulky or requires special handling requirements. We also provide a flexible front-end UI with a micro front-end architecture. So you can configure the user experience. Once again, we provide a library of UI components, but you can also create new ones. One example is a customer who has a Slack integration for their customer service reps to escalate orders, because that's what they use as their internal order escalation mechanism. And so the customer service rep can press a button in the UI, it triggers a notification that gets posted to Slack, and then the appropriate team member can handle that escalation. And our AWS architecture is key to providing this flexibility and digital agility.
That's impressive. Usually, you know, you forget, or you usually the store associates and internal constituents comes last when it comes to, you know, addressing UI need for them. And the fact that Fluent Commerce allows that is really helpful to meet those needs. Now, if I summarize what we talked, it seems like there are a lot of different components or microservices which Fluent Commerce has, ranging from inventory management to fulfillment planning, execution, order workflow, and more. That very flexible architecture allows you to extend and provide multiple functionality in flexible architecture as a multi-tenant also. And using the depth and breadth of AWS services, you are able to process not only the batch data, but also streaming data, either coming from point of sale or warehouse, and provide the real-time visibility of inventory and provide faster decisions on allocation. In my ideal world of OMS, right, giving the dials or levers to the business for either the user experience, i.e. the delivery speed, or the profit margin, or the warehouse capacity. Like if I have these three dial as a retailer, and I can adjust those and let AI figure out what's best optimization is for those value or dials I pick. How are you looking at AI and using AI within Fluent Commerce platform?
Yeah, so we're looking at AI from a few different perspectives. One of the other big differentiators we have is that we capture a lot of event data throughout both the pre-purchased and the post-purchase journey that can be great data signals for training and testing an AI model, particularly for demand forecasting and sourcing optimization. One of our customers, Aldo, actually is currently building their own model for that purpose. They want to further improve their inventory turns, out-of-stock reductions, and reduce delivery and end-of-season recall costs. One of the reasons they chose Fluent Order Management was because it provided the flexibility to consume the output of their model and factor that into real-time sourcing decisions.
That is great. So what are other AI/ML use cases does OMS support? Because you said you have a lot of data, which is the key to drive any AI, and you probably have a lot of clean data, and I'm curious what other use case you have seen your customer enable and you are also thinking.
Yeah, so one area is around estimated delivery dates. AI can be used to provide more accurate delivery date estimates to customers during the buying journey, which helps increase conversions and customer trust. It can also enhance AI-driven demand forecasting accuracy by providing visibility into digital demand signals. For example, the ratio between the number of stock availability checks that are happening and the actual number of orders that are actually being placed, because we see large variations. For example, a commoditized white t-shirt, it might be a ratio of 3-1, right? 3 stock checks to one order. For a high-end luxury good, that might be up to 700-1. And so that data has a lot of predictive value. Fluent Order Management can also share data with other AI-driven solutions to optimize their output. So we're exploring right now pricing recommendation engines and using inventory data to increase those or optimize those recommendations, digital app platforms to optimize ad platforms to help increase sell-through, hit sell-through targets, and increase inventory turns, commerce search to increase add-to-cart rates and also conversions. And then it can also share, like, say, average delivery distance of an order or whether it was shipped via a low-carbon delivery method with your AI-driven carbon management solution too. So there are a lot of different use cases we're exploring right now.
That's awesome. It seems like the having good inventory and availability data is like core to the commerce, and it enables so much of an use case from AI standpoint, pricing optimization to search and digital ad platform. That's pretty impressive. So tell me, how can people learn more about this going forward?
Yeah, so we're in the AWS Marketplace. So you can definitely check out the the AWS Marketplace for more information. Or if you'd like to read more about the Aldo and Psycho Bunny case studies, the links are available in the video description.
That's great. Thanks, Nicola, for your time today. I learned a lot.
Thank you, Ronak. Always a pleasure.